Switching from low-flux to high-flux dialysis allows the removal of waste products of middle-sized molecules, resulting in the clinical improvement of symptoms that are associated with such uremic toxins. Continued research results in the development of hemodiafiltration, which combines convection with diffusion to enhance removal of middle-sized molecules during treatments. HDF demonstrates improved removal of, for example, beta-2 microglobulin, a surrogate marker for the efficiency of convective therapies, which is linked to cardiovascular mortality. Additionally, some clinical studies on high-volume HDF found significant improvements in all-cause mortality and cardiovascular outcomes. Further advances in membrane technology gave rise to increased mean pore sizes for the removal of higher molecular weight toxins. However, these also come along with increased removal of physiologically important large proteins like serum albumin, which constitutes about 55% of the total protein plasma mass. Whether the benefits of these membranes outweigh the risks of albumin loss requires further investigations, as well as data to reflect on the mortality risk of ESKD patients. How efficient membranes remove waste products is described by the sieving coefficient. A sieving coefficient for a particular solute may maximally be indicated at 1, where unrestricted transfer of a solute from the patient blood across the dialyzer membrane to the filtrate occurs. The sieving coefficient therefore reflects the ratio of solute concentration between the filtrate and patient blood. Does the sieving coefficient of a membrane hit 0.1, 10% of solute from patient blood is going to be removed by convection reaching the cutoff. The progression from cellulose to synthetic polymeric membranes has led to improvements in the removal of uremic waste products as well as hemocompatibility. A combination of biological and engineering factors defines the separation processes between the membrane compartments and impacts the efficacy, efficiency, and quality of therapy delivered to the patient. Therefore, research efforts continue towards improving membrane properties to yield them even more hemocompatible for better patient outcomes.